Today, an important issue has come up before the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, and it related to giving a boost to the real estate in the construction sector. The construction sector contributes 8% to the GDP. It is the second largest recipient of FDI in the country. And it gives a large employment. The current figure of employment is about 40 million. There are various challenges before the construction sector. And the government has been trying over the last year to improve upon the functioning of the construction sector. If you recollect, we had simplified the arbitration law. We have now provided for fast-track arbitrations so that in a large number of infrastructure projects, the process of dispute redressal could be made easier. Establishment of commercial courts and having a commercial court division in every high court was one of the steps. So today an important proposal of the Niti Aayog came up before the cabinet and the same was approved. The proposal has several key features, but I'll just address you on the five important features in relation to the construction sector. The first proposal is that wherever there are disputes pending between public bodies and construction contractors under the old Arbitration Act, which was time consuming, there will be an option with consent to shift over to the new arbitration procedures, where there is a procedure for a cheaper and a quicker fast track arbitration process. But the second aspect is the most important decision. That a large number of construction companies have in relation to their projects against government bodies and public sector bodies arbitral awards in their favor. Now these awards have been challenged before the courts. The scope of challenge are now under law is quite limited. And as long as the challenge remains pending, even interest starts, keeps mounting up. Today, the cabinet decided that when an award has been made and a public body is challenging the same, against a margin-free bank guarantee being given by the contractor, 75% of the amount will have to be released to him. And this 75% of the amount will have to be spent by the contractor in completing the project and in discharging the bank and financial institutions' dues. If he has any surplus, then he can spend it on further expansion of his projects. Today, one of the key problems is that there are a large number of awards where payments have not been made, and consequently, the contractors have not been able to pay the banks. And therefore, it has adversely impacted the balance sheet of both the companies and the banks itself. As a result of which the projects have come to a halt. So to give liquidity into this sector, where awards have been made against a margin-free bank guarantee, 75% of the monies would have to be released. And the same will have to be pumped either into the project or into the banks. And if anything is left thereafter, the same can be used for further projects. The third important decision is that in all new contracts relating to construction, there will be a conciliation board provision. And this conciliation board will comprise of independent subject experts. Now, this is being done for the reason that when commercial circumstances change and public servants are reluctant to participate in the renegotiations, there will be a contractual mechanism under which those terms could be renegotiated without bringing the projects to a standstill. The fourth suggestion is that in contracts which are entered into by public authorities and public bodies, the item rate contracts would be replaced by a turnkey contract. And a model draft turnkey contract proposal will be circulated. And lastly, the Department of Financial Services and the Reserve Bank of India would try and prepare a policy on how to deal with those companies which have got a lot of stressed assets in the real estate sector. We hope that a series of these decisions will pump in a lot of liquidity into the sector, activate real estate projects which have, and infrastructure projects which have been stranded for some time, and support the entire process of dispute resolution in relation to construction and real estate. And this is particularly because there is a huge employment potential. There is a, the sector itself is a very large contributor to GDP, and in future we need more housing, more urbanization, more commercial spaces. So this will take care of that. Thank you. Thank you.
Is there any questions, please?
This is Ruchi Bhatia from ED Now. Just wanted to check, when you were saying a policy that RBI and DFS together will make, what will this policy entail and what are the kind of things?
देखिए उस पॉलिसी में ये उद्देश्य होगा कि किसी प्रकार की वो वर्कआउट करेंगे. अभी तो सुझाव है हम लोगों का कि जो स्ट्रेस्ड एसेट्स है रियल एस्टेट सेक्टर के, उनको डिस्ट्रेस किस तरीके से किया जा सकता है. मैं मानता हूं कि अगर 75% of the awarded amount real estate companies को मिल जाता है, so ये अपने आप में काफी significant होगा. It will pump in a lot of liquidity. Now, over and above this, if some steps are possible, the central bank and the DFS will decide that.
So we're essentially looking at the reworking of the loans in progress when we speak of de-stressing the real estate.
No, you see, we've taken a pragmatic because there are awards. The awards have been challenged. We are conscious of the fact that arbitral awards, the scope of challenge is very limited. But then pending that challenge, because the judicial process is time consuming, the economic activity comes to a halt and the interest keeps mounting up. So the whole system is suffering. Now, if you want to challenge it, please challenge it, but pay 75% of the amount against a bank guarantee. and so that the real estate sector itself doesn't stop.
Sir, you know, what's the cutoff date or what's the applicability? Are these applicable to existing projects as well?
Of course they are applicable to all.
Is there a particular
that's the whole idea.
Right.
Otherwise, if we only make it applicable for future,
right,
we'll be there in the future if the same companies are not able to survive at present.
So
obviously, it's applicable to all.
Is
there
a
technicality in terms of suits that are pending? Will there be a date that prior to this date, the suits that were filed, they will be made up?
No, the whole idea is to de-stress the sector.
See that stalled infrastructure projects get.
So even if the challenges are pending, the policy applies to all of them.
There is a, you issued a press release, the PIB
will give you a press release. A certain threshold if you invest in India, then the availability of visa, the availability of the right to purchase assets, the availability of employment for family members. Now there is a detailed policy to that effect which has been approved by the cabinet today. You will get a detailed press statement to that.
Sorry.